In this video, I'm going to show you a full tutorial on using ChatGPT for your business. From snagging your free ChatGPT account, getting started using it, to more advanced ways to capitalize on this for your business to save you tons of time and money. So let's get into it. All right, so first I'm going to show you step-by-step how to create your own free ChatGPT account. So the first thing you're going to do is open a new tab or go to Google, and you're going to type in ChatGPT. And it's going to say OpenAI introducing ChatGPT. You're going to go ahead and click on that link. Right here it says try ChatGPT. You're going to click on that link. And this is where it would prompt you to set up your own account or sign in. As you can see, I'm already signed in to my ChatGPT account, but registering for your free account is as easy as just creating a username and password. There's no credit card required. It's 100% free. For me, I just linked my Gmail account. So literally with two clicks, I created my own ChatGPT account for free. So once you've done that, you're going to log in to ChatGPT and it's going to look like this. So yours will be empty on the left-hand side, but mine has all of these prompts right here. These are the past prompts that I have typed in to ChatGPT. And in this main section here, it says ChatGPT, here's some examples, here's the capabilities, here's some limitations. Down here, it says send a message. This is the most important part of ChatGPT. And this is where you're going to enter what's called a prompt or ask it a question. So let's just start out with something really easy, and then I'm gonna get into the more advanced prompts specifically for business owners. But I remember when I first logged into ChatGPT for the first time, the very first thing I typed in was to write my husband a birthday card. I don't know why, it was just the first thing I could think of. So write a
birthday card for my 35-year-old husband and make it
lovey-dovey. Let's see what it comes up with. All right, dear Aaron, happy 35th birthday to the love of my life. I'm so blessed to have you in my world and I'm grateful for every moment we share together. Today I celebrate the amazing person that you are, blah, blah, blah. Pretty cool, right? How it can literally just write a birthday card. And what's crazy is a friend of a friend just got married and my friend told me that her friend used ChatGPT to actually write her thank you speech for her reception for her wedding. And I thought that was hilarious and genius. Okay, so now that you know a little bit about ChatGPT, where things are, how it works, it really is quite simple. Let's get into the more advanced prompts for business owners that you can save a ton of time and money using this AI, ChatGPT, for your business. Okay, so the first prompt I want to talk about is you can use ChatGPT to name a product or your business or really anything. So let's go ahead and come up with
5 names for ebooks about how to make side money
by renting out your camper. I actually have a student who's in this niche right now, so I thought it'd be kind of fun to do this. So number one, the camperpreneur. That's cute. A guide to making extra income by renting out your camper. Wheels and deals, how to turn your camper into a profitable side hustle. That's like legit good. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. Roaming riches, a step-by-step guide to renting out your camper. Camp out in cash, rolling in the dough. These are hilarious. I like how it comes up with a title that's like cute and funny and a pun. And then it tells you word for word, step by step, like exactly what the literal meaning is. And I think that's a really good combination for a title or name for anything. Okay, so the next prompt and thing you can use ChatGPT for is coming up with your social media captions. So let's put in, come up with a social
media caption talking about how you can make money with ebooks and that they should comment the word ebook to receive my free, I always mix up the I and the E, obviously, to receive my free ebook starter.
Let's see what it comes up with. Did you know that writing and selling ebooks can be a great source of passive income? If you're interested in getting started, comment ebook below and I'll send you my free ebook starter toolkit. And it even came up with hashtags. Pretty cool. Let's try another one. Come up with a
an Instagram caption that talks about the importance and profitability of online courses and how I've made over $8 million from online courses and that they should comment the word course. No, not a good idea. Idea to get my free course idea discovery
ebook for free. All right, let's see what it comes up with. Very specific. I might want to use these captions, right? Ready to turn your knowledge and expertise into an online course? Already off to a good start. I like how it even uses emojis. How cute is that? With the right idea and the right strategy, it's absolutely possible. I should know my online courses have generated over $8 million in revenue. Want to learn how to discover your perfect course idea? Comment idea below and I'll send you my free course idea discovery workbook. Oh my gosh. This is amazing. Like, think about how much time this is gonna save you to create captions for your social media. Okay, the next prompt and thing that you can use ChatGPT for is actually writing sales copy. So you can use ChatGPT to write an entire sales page or sales email. So let me show you how you can use ChatGPT to write a sales email. And remember, the more information you input into ChatGPT, not only the better it's going to be, the longer it's going to be, it's going to have the right information. So really take your time formulating the question or the prompt, because let's say you take 5 to 10 minutes to formulate a really good prompt, you're going to have that email or sales page written versus having to spend hours writing the email and or sales page yourself. Okay, so let's say create a
series of three emails. Telling my story about how I got started with online courses, how I transitioned from trading my time for money with photography to earning consistent passive income with online courses.
Let's see here. I think I'm going to input my actual offer. So I will say,
the course I'm offering for sale for the next 3 days is as follows. See how this goes.
All right. So I'm just going to copy and paste the different parts of the offer. Full price and the doors will close. Okay. I don't know. This is a lot of information, but let's see what it comes up with. From trading time for money to earning passive income, I wanted to share my story with you about how I transitioned from trading my time for money with photography to earning consistent passive income with online courses. I was a successful photographer and I loved what I did, but I was always trading my time for money. I knew I wanted to find a way to leverage my knowledge and expertise to create a stream of passive income that would allow me to earn more. That's when I discovered the power of online courses. This is really good. What? I created my first course and launched it to my email list, and it was an instant success. I might need to edit some of this a little bit. I was able to earn money while I slept, traveled, spent time with my family, and now I want to share my knowledge with you. For the next 3 days, I'm offering my profitable courses curriculum, which will give you an exact roadmap to creating a 6 or 7 figure course. I think it searched my website because this is something that I have on there. That's cool. This bundle includes everything you need to get started, from course creation templates to selling and follower growth strategies. Plus you'll have 24/7 Q&A, blah, blah, blah. Don't miss this opportunity. Best Molly. Wow. So really, this is such a great starting point. You just need to tweak it a little bit and add your links, obviously, because they need to go to your sales page or checkout page to actually make this purchase. Discover your profitable online course. Are you struggling to come up with your course idea? I know it's frustrating. That's why I created the Find Your Profitable. Wow. So it created an email specific to one of the elements in my offer. What? That is so cool. This one, last chance. Okay, last chance. It knows there's only 3 emails, so it knows to make the 3rd email the last chance. This is crazy. I'm definitely going to use this to write my next series of emails because it's such a great starting out point. Like, it's never going to be probably 100% perfect, but if you can just go in, make some edits, put in your links, this is crazy. Like, I would have to pay a copywriter thousands of dollars to write a series of emails or a sales page. So talk about saving time and money for your business. Okay, so this next prompt or way you can use ChatGPT is to answer customer service emails. Now, I've never actually used ChatGPT to do this, so I thought it'd be fun. I went into Help Scout, grabbed an actual customer service email that we received recently, and I'm gonna paste it in here just to see what ChatGPT will do, because it clearly doesn't have enough information maybe to answer this email. So I don't know, we'll see. Please answer
this email we received to our customer service inbox.
Okay. Dear Melissa, thank you for reaching out to us. We'd be happy to assist you with your balance and payment plan. To determine your current balance, we would need a bit more information from you, see, because it doesn't know. Could you please provide us with your account number, blah, blah, blah. In terms of paying off your balance, there are a few options. You can make a one-time payment in full, blah, blah. I mean, it's really good given that it has literally no information to go off of. But this is definitely one way that you could use ChatGPT because, as you can see, it's talking to the customer in a very nice way. Like, thank you so much for reaching out. We're happy to assist you. Like, this is really good customer service lingo. So I do think this is a good starting off point. And this is something you could use or tell your customer service, you know, they could use this as a starting off point to save them some time. I think it's pretty neat. Okay, the last two prompts I want to show you how to use ChatGPT for your business to save you time and money. The first one is how to create a free PDF that you can use as a free download to your audience to convert your social media followers to email subscribers. And the second thing that I just recently discovered is you can use ChatGPT to actually research your competitors in your niche. Because a lot of times when you're starting out a business, you don't even know what competitors there are. You don't know, you know, what else is already out there. Like, what are they already offering? What are their prices? Like, all that different stuff. And I found out that you can use ChatGPT for this, which is super cool. So let's first start out with the freebie. So I like to create free PDFs that can be downloaded where someone will put in their name and email address to download this freebie. And in turn, they are now on my email list, which helps me to build my business and my potential customer base. So let's use the camper rental space again. So create a
two-page PDF on how to prepare your camper
to rent out to customers. I don't know, let's see what it comes up with. Okay, so it thinks that I wanted to create a PDF, so, oh, but it still wrote it. I don't need it to create a PDF document, that's just my wording, but what's cool is even though it can't, which I didn't want it to, it's still answering me and writing out the language, which is cool. Okay, so it came up with how to prepare your camper for renting out to customers. Renting out your camper can be a great way for extra income before you start, blah, blah, blah. Step one, deep clean. Step two, check your camper systems. Three, make necessary repairs. Four, check your camper safety, blah, 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 blah. Now, this is not my niche, so I don't know how accurate this is, but I'm gonna guess that it's a great starting off point, and you could just go in and add your own touch, add some photos, copy and paste this into Canva, design it, and then you can download it as a PDF. How much time is this going to save you? Okay, last but not least, I'm gonna show you how ChatGPT can be used to research competitors in your niche. So I'm gonna go ahead and put in, find 10
competitors in the online education
space. I don't know, let's see what it comes up with. Okay, so I did this earlier and it came up with a better answer. So let me find what prompt that was because I'm not looking for this type of answer. I'm looking for more of like brand faces and solo type people. Okay, so I found the prompt that I did earlier. I wrote top competitors who teach online business. I feel like this was similar to what I just put in, but you know, the wording does matter. So again, now it's answering with Udemy, Coursera, whatever. Before it was like Pat Flynn, Amy Porterfield, blah, blah, blah. So that is interesting to me that before it gave me the answer I wanted and I even put word for word the exact same prompt and now it's not giving me the right answer. I have a feeling it's because I'm in an existing chat. So let me start with a new chat and put the same prompt in and let's just see what it gives us now. Okay, now it's giving me the answer that I'm wanting. And so what happened was I had already been asking a lot of questions about courses. So that's why it gave me like Udemy, Coursera, blah, 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 because it thought that that's the direction I wanted to go. But when I created a new chat in the upper left-hand corner, now it's giving me my answer because it doesn't have previous data to go off of. So it gave me Marie Forleo, Pat Flynn, Amy Porterfield, Jeff Walker, Ramit Sethi. Like, this is the answer that I was looking for. So that's a little something to keep in mind when it comes to ChatGPT is as you're talking in a chat, it's learning about what you want and it's going to give you answers based on those previous questions. So if you want it to kind of like not know anything about you and start fresh, you're gonna have to click a new chat in the upper left-hand corner. Now that you know how to get started with ChatGPT and even more advanced ways to use ChatGPT, you might be wondering what other tools are out there using AI to save your business more time and more money. But how do you do that? Well, it all starts with watching this video next here, because when you pair what you just learned with what's in this video, it's gonna be so much more powerful. See you in the next video.